The fourth book in my elementary science series is called Science in the Age of Reason. Now, this book starts where the previous book left off. It starts with Edmund Haley. If you've ever heard of Halley's Comet, he's the fellow who discovered it. And he was the first one to really figure out that comets are kind of like planets, that they orbit the sun just like planets do, but they orbit in kind of a strange way. And the reason they're only visible for a short time is because they're only close enough to the sun to be visible for a short time. So he was the one who predicted when his comet would come back, and he unfortunately died before he could see that prediction come to pass, but his prediction was correct, so we named the comet after him. And we start with him, and we go through all of the 1700s and just a little bit of the 1800s. We end with Gay-Lussac, who was very important in chemistry. He explained a little bit about how gases work, and so he's an important figure in chemistry. And along the way, the student gets introduced to a lot of very interesting characters. There's a fellow by the name of Cavendish who was so reclusive that he didn't want his portrait ever done. And so the only reason we know a little bit about what he looked like was an architect was having dinner in a cafe and saw him and realized that no one had drawn a sketch of him. So without his permission, he drew a sketch of William Cavendish, and that's the only reason we know a little bit about what he looks like. Now, William Cavendish was a very important fellow because he told us what water is made of, and he told us a lot about how gravity works as well. So the student learns all sorts of things like that and gets introduced to some interesting characters. One person who has a fairly famous name, his name is Erasmus Darwin. He was the grandfather of Charles Darwin, who's a very important scientist later on in the next book. And Erasmus Darwin was a well-known physician who really believed that being fat was very important to being good, to being healthy. And so he became very, very fat. He became so fat that when he visited a house, he hired someone who was heavier than him to walk into the house first to make sure the floorboards could hold him up. Now, surprisingly, he did a lot of really good science. He did much better science than Charles Darwin did later on. And even though Charles Darwin's the one everybody remembers, Erasmus Darwin was probably a more important figure in science history than his grandson Charles. But nevertheless, the student will be introduced to all sorts of very interesting characters like that. And along the way, the student will learn wonderful things about how weather works, how clouds form, why it's cooler as you go up in elevation. And the student will learn about different facts about how gases form. Student will learn what electroplating is. The student will also learn how electricity works, both the static electricity that makes your hair stand up on end, but also the kind of electricity that comes from a battery, because at this time period, batteries were invented by a guy by the name of Alessandro Volta. So the student will learn all of these different things. The student will also start seeing how at this time in history, some scientists, not all of them, in fact, a minority, but still some pretty important names, started turning their back on Scripture and started coming up with their own ideas about how creation works. And you'll see, the student will see how those ideas are wrong, but nevertheless, how they were the first step in turning some scientists away from Scripture and making them believe in other things. So the student will learn a little bit about that as well. And like all of my other books, you'll be doing these lessons and these experiments together. It's a multi-grade approach for all elementary level students. So all your elementary level students, regardless of their age, will be doing the experiments, will be listening to you, reading to them, will be doing the review exercises, and it'll be a great family time to help you learn more about science and learn more about how science developed in this period of human history.